What's going on, everybody? Today, I want to talk about the latest research from NVIDIA surrounding GameGAN. So, you know, historically, most of the time when we have AI in games, the idea is the AI is acting as some sort of agent within some game environment. Well, with GameGAN, the idea is instead to have the AI be the game itself. So the AI is replacing the game engine. So either you or maybe some reinforcement learning agent can play within this game that is kind of dictated by an AI rather than a game engine. So the AI is in control of not only what you see, but the rules, the logic, and all of that of the actual game environment itself. Now, we've seen lots of similar examples to this, such as research from Georgia Tech that recreated a game scenes in a playthrough, showing that the AI at least understood concepts like a character landing on a surface and not being able to just clip through walls and so on. But this was actually a replay of scenes it had already seen. We've also seen lots of examples where AI can predict next frames. So that's pretty similar to a video game, right? Right? You're trying to move, and the next frame should look something like what you would expect if you move. And we've even seen AI that does things like pix to pix, so it can either enhance images or reskin something, and so on. And then maybe the closest related thing to this would be the World Models paper back in late 2018, where the kind of concept here was very similar. It was like, let the agent learn the environment and then kind of sort of dream the environment and interact within this dream of an environment. The big difference here, though, I think if you just even look at some of the clips from there, is it's very clearly a very blurry dream. There's no consistency. And in terms of creating an environment, it's not reliable as an environment. You definitely, it clearly looks like the thing that we saw, and maybe reinforcement learning agents can learn some things from this environment, but there obviously is a huge amount of improvement that needs to be made here. And that's where the research around GameGAN has kind of changed everything, where the what is produced is an actual playable environment, either by you or theoretically some sort of AI agent. But it's a realistic environment that is mapped from the games that it was trained on. So in this case, they were trained on both Pac-Man and Doom. You can actually play them. Various rules are in place, like you can't go through walls, for example. If you leave an area and then come back, it should hopefully look the same. Obviously, that won't always be the case. There will be screw-ups. But this is the concept. So it's not like a dream where things are just constantly able to just change on you moving forward. It's an actual map. So with like World Models, for example, they would use like a race car game. Well, that's okay, because as you continue through that road, the road can constantly be changing into the future, and there's really no big deal there. But in the case of something like Pac-Man, where there's a maze that you have to get through, it's going to be highly troubling if if the maze is changing on you as you're going through it. Definitely Pac-Man hard mode there. So with Pac-Man, the training data consisted of these partially observed states, which were effectively zoomed-in views with Pac-Man at the center moving around the much larger map. And I think the idea was, initially when you have the full Pac-Man map, your agent, you could see the whole map, so it was maybe less likely the map would change. But if you zoom in on Pac-Man and you're moving around the map, you could later recreate that map and then see how well did we remember where certain elements were. And at least looking at the paper and the very anecdotal examples that they shared, it looks like it does a pretty impressive job. And what's really cool about that is it kind of comes down to, like, I think generative adversarial networks in general, generating something that looks about what you might see, that's not very impressive anymore. But what is impressive is this like environmental knowledge, which requires long-term memory. So this is memory that we really have never seen before. This is a problem that plagues machine learning and deep learning in all aspects, both natural language, trying to carry on a conversation or remember the topic that was talked about maybe even five minutes ago is an eternity to AI. Same thing in a game. So if you leave a room and come back, you would expect that room to be the same, but AI is not typically very good at that. So I think that's the biggest breakthrough here, is that you can leave and come back. And this is all thanks to the memory module, as they're calling it, which seems to do a pretty good job of keeping the game map static. Now, obviously, Pac-Man in general, that game map is a pretty small map. But again, just like 5 minutes ago in a conversation is an eternity for an AI, I think the Pac-Man map is an incredible start of being able to leave some area and come back, and that area looks the same. That really, truly is incredible. So I will put links in the description to the research paper and any other links that we end up getting. There's a short video on YouTube that I can link. And then hopefully at some point they're going to post the code. They do say that the code will come soon, so whenever that is. And I definitely look forward to playing with it. I think both just trying to transfer it to other games, I'd like to look deeper into that memory module that they've done, because I think that there are certain concepts there that could possibly be extrapolated out to other areas of research. So that's going to be very interesting to check out. And obviously play the game. So, you know, yes, you can do world models and you can kind of play in a dream scenario. But it's nothing like what we're seeing here. And so I think that's like the coolest thing, is to be able to play in some AI generated, environment. Like, that's really cool, where it's not just the visuals, it's the logic and other assets, like the enemies and the food and all that kind of stuff. Like, that's pretty crazy. Now, I know the graphics aren't, you know, Unreal 5 graphics or anything, but it's kind of cool to think that possibly in the future, this could be the game engine. You know, we struggle writing, like, even some of the most basic physics engines for games. So it wouldn't be too surprising if the first realistic kind of Turing test physics engine is really made by an AI rather than some hard-coded rules. So, I think the whole concept is really interesting. Also, obviously, just for reinforcement learning in general and training agents. You know, we spend so much time writing these environments for agents to learn within. When we could, in theory, just kind of record some sequences and have an AI that just handles it from there. So that's very interesting. So anyways, really cool stuff coming out of NVIDIA. I look forward to being able to play with this code. I hope that they release it soon. All right, till next time.